Autumn, for many the most beautiful season. But for gardeners, piles and piles of fallen leaves. What do you do with them? Rake them? Bag them? Throw them in the trash? Or worse, burn them? Stop right there. You are looking at the most valuable resource your garden can get. This is not waste. This is the raw material for black gold, the most fertile soil, humus, and compost that will bring your garden back to life. But who has the time to wait 1 or 2 years for all this to decompose? Today, I'll show you how to speed up that process and get rich compost from dry leaves in the shortest possible time. We're talking about weeks, not years. First, a simple trick to make leaves decompose faster. If you want speed, you must shred the leaves. Makes sense, right? Whole leaves stick together like old newspapers and block air and water. That slows everything down. When you shred them, you increase the surface area for microbes to work on, and the process speeds up dramatically. The easiest way? Spread the leaves on the lawn and go over them with a lawnmower. If your mower has a bag, perfect. You'll collect a nice mix of shredded leaves and grass. And grass? Yes, and that's the secret ingredient. Why does a pile of dry leaves decompose so slowly? The answer is simple. Chemistry. Dry leaves are what we call brown material. They're full of carbon. Carbon is the fuel for compost, but it lacks the spark. That spark is nitrogen. Nitrogen is found in green material, and it's food for billions of microorganisms that do all the work. Without nitrogen, the microbes are hungry and lazy. The process drags on forever. The magic ratio of carbon to nitrogen is 25 to 1. In practice, that means for every 3 parts of dry leaves, add 1 part of nitrogen-rich material, like fresh grass clippings. Other good additions, banana peels. Apple and potato peels. Coffee grounds, excellent. Crushed eggshells. Even a little wood ash, but only in small amounts. What you shouldn't add, meat, dairy, or oils. They attract pests and slow down decomposition. You can also add a bit of manure, horse, chicken, or cattle. That's a perfect activator. And young weeds before they go to seed are great too. And finally, the secret ingredient, a handful of ordinary garden soil, or even better, some old compost. Think of it as a vaccine. It brings in all the good bacteria and fungi that start the magic. Now, how do you build the pile? Not by mixing everything together, but by layering it. Start with coarse twigs for drainage and air from below. Layer 1, brown, a thick layer of shredded leaves, around 20 centimeters. Layer 2, green, grass clippings, kitchen scraps, or manure. About 5 to 10 centimeters. Then sprinkle a shovel of soil or old compost, your natural starter. And the key, water. Each layer must be damp, like a wrung out sponge. Not dripping wet, but not dry either. Some gardeners even water the compost with potato or rice water. It speeds up the process. Then repeat all the layers until your composter is full. In just 24 to 48 hours, the microbes start working and the pile heats up. Because of that heat, you need oxygen, so turn the compost every 7 days. If it's too dry, add some water. At the end of the process, you get the most fertile soil you can give your plants. It improves soil structure, retains moisture, feeds your plants, and fills your garden with billions of beneficial microbes. And the best part, you made it yourself, for free, from something you would have thrown away. The significance of compost is best reflected in the fact that it is called the black gold of gardeners. Its use is an excellent natural way to enrich the soil with nutrients while simultaneously recycling organic waste, such as leaves. You literally get fertilizer from leaves, grass, and kitchen scraps. With regular use of compost in the garden, you can significantly increase your yield. Here is how you will apply it in the garden. Apply a layer of compost, about 2 to 3 centimeters thick, around the plants as mulch, or lightly incorporate it into the soil in spring and autumn. Your vegetables and flowers will be immensely grateful and will repay you with larger fruits and more beautiful blossoms. So rake up those dry leaves and make compost from them, but never take everything from the lawn. Leave some behind so your lawn can naturally feed itself. If this video was helpful, share it with friends who love gardening. Subscribe for more simple and powerful tips. And tell me in the comments, what do you do with your leaves? The easiest way to support our work is to like the video. Click the follow button, then the bell, and finally confirm the bell. This means a lot to us. Thank you for your support.